बिस्मिल्लाह रहमान रहीम, वेलकम टू द कैंटर पब्लिशर्स वीडियो लेसन्स। बिफोर स्टार्टिंग द लेसन, डियर स्टूडेंट, यू मस्ट हैव विद यू क्लास 5 इंग्लिश टेक्स्ट बुक, रिसोर्स पैक एंड समर पैक। रिसोर्स पैक इज फॉर पेरेंट्स एंड टीचर्स गाइडेंस। यू कैन ऑल्सो डाउनलोड इट फ्रॉम कैंटर पब्लिशर ऑफिशियल वेबसाइट। टूडे वी विल स्टार्ट अवर लेसन फ्रॉम यूनिट नंबर 3, अ विजिट टू अ विलेज। एस लॉज ऑफ दिस लेसन आर, चेंज द नंबर ऑफ मोर रेगुलर एंड इरेगुलर नाउंस and nouns with no change in number. Now look at the page number 24 of your textbook. We have a grammar section of singular and plural noun here. Now, I hope you know about the singular and plural nouns, because we have also learned these two in our previous class. Singular indicates to one item or one person. And plural indicates to more than one item or person. Here look at these singular and plural nouns. Nouns can be either singular or plural. You know the noun. Noun names a person, place or things. Nouns can be either singular and plural. Here look at the singular nouns first. When we talk about a person, animal, place or thing, we use a singular noun. We use a or an, singular noun. When we write a singular noun, we use a before words, beginning with the consonant sound. I hope you are familiar with the consonant sound and vowel sound. We add an before the vowel sound. Vowel sounds are those words which starts with the sound of a, e, I, o, u. And the rest of the sounds are consonant sounds. These are the vowel sounds, and the word which starts with the vowel sound, we add an before that word, like an apple, an orange, etc. Now look at here the example of singular noun: a shape, a train, a woman, a flower, a key, a comb, a girl, a slide, a van, a swing, a map, a letter. But some words don't follow this rule. For example, we use an, not a, before these words that begin with H here. An air. I told you the words which start with the sound of vowel sound. A, E, O, I. Here the, in these words, in these three words, the H is silent here. An air. If you pronounce this word air, which has a H in the start, but the H is silent. So this word is starting with the sound air, and air is the vowel sound here. So that's why we have added N here. And look at the second one, an R. It is starting with the sound of O here. An honor. It is again starting with the O sound here. So all these three words here starting with the vowel sound, and I told you we use an before the vowel sound word to indicate its number. We use an before words beginning with the vowel sound, like an all, aeroplane, X, an igloo, an egg, an orange, an umbrella, an envelope, an engine, and an R. Now look at the plural nouns here. When we are talking about two or more people, animals, places or thing, we use plural noun. Most noun are made plural by adding S at the end. Look at here the singular noun, and when we change it into plural, it has a S in it at the end. It shows that the animal, bird, animal, people or the things are plural, more than one here, like bird, birds. Look at here, we have added S to make it plural. Egg, eggs. Nest, nest. Camel, camels. Flower, flowers. Photo, photos. Doll, dolls. Game, games. Shirt, shirts. Now look at the other way of changing from singular to plural. Some plural noun end in ES. When the last letter of singular nouns are SH, SCH, S, double S or X, you usually add ES to form the plural. Here we saw that we have added only s here to make it plural. Now we will add es here to make it plural, because the words are ending with these here, sh, ch, s, double s or x here. Look at the singular form here, beach. It will become beaches if it's more than one. So what we have added? We have added es here. Bush, bushes. Sandwich, sandwiches. Branch, branches. Dish, dishes. Fox, foxes. Box, boxes. Dress, dresses. Glass, glasses. Some plural nouns end in ies. Nouns like following are made plural by changing y to I and adding es. Now look at the example here. Look at the singular form here. It is ending with the letter y here. But what we will do when we make it plural? Yes, we will add ies to make it plural, and we will remove the y in the plural form. So it is indicating that butterflies are more than one. Just remove the y here in the plural form and add ies here to make it plural. All these example of this type of singular plural: canary, canaries; lily, lilies; candy. You can see in plural form there is ies in all the words, and the singular, it's only y here. Candies, flies, baby, babies; lady, ladies; fairy, fairies; story, stories. Now look at the third way. If there is a vowel before y, we add s to form the plural. If we have a sound of vowel, I have told you I, E, O, U are the vowel sound. So if we have the vowel sound before the Y, what we will do? We will only add S here to make it plural. Like key, keys; days, days. The A and the E here, the vowel sound. Turkey, turkeys; toy, toys; tray, trays; valet, valets. Now look at the now fourth one. If a noun ends in F, we often change F to V and add ES to make it plural. Look at here, we have F in the singular noun. In the last letter is F here. So what we will do, how we will make it plural? We will simply add V, E and S at the end to make it plural. Calf, calves; shelf, shelves; leaf, leaves; loaf, loaves; and so on. Now look at here the another way of making singular to plural. Some nouns ends in F, we often change F to V and add ES to make it plural. Here you can see here chef, chefs; roof, roofs; cliff, cliffs. We will not any VES here like this one. No, we will not do this in this one. We just only add S here. Now look at here another way. With some word that end in FE, we change F to V and S. Okay. Now look at this word, knife here. It is ending with the FE letter at the end. So what we will do? We will add only VES at the end and remove the FE in the plural form. Like knives, knife; life, lives; wife, wives. Now look at the another way of singular to plural. If a noun ends in O, we just add S to form plural. Look at these singular nouns here. They are ending with the letter O, the sound O. So what we will do? We will just only add S to make it plural. Rhino, rhinos; hippo, hippos; zoo, zoos. Look at the last one here. With some nouns that end in O, we add ES to form that plural. Some nouns which ends with the letter O, we will not add only ES here, but we also add ES here to make it plural. Like tomato, tomatoes; hero, heroes; mango, mangoes. Look at the page number 26 here. Some plural nouns don't follow the S rule. They don't end in S, ES, IES or VES. Instead, the word changes its form. How? They are not ending with the S, ES, IES and VES. They are the irregular noun. Look at here, mouse, mice. We just change the spelling to make it plural. These are the irregular noun. Don't end with S, ES and IES and VES here. Child, children, you can see the difference of spelling here. The singular form is child and the plural form is children. Goose, geese, foot, feet, man, men, ox, oxen. Now look at here, some plural nouns are the same as the singular noun. They don't have any plural form. They can be both singular and plural. Sheep, sheep, fish, fish, deer, deer. Some nouns are always plural. Binoculars, goggles, pliers, jeans, socks, glasses. Because these plural are a pair. If you can see socks, there are always two socks. A pair of socks. Because these are all nouns are in pair. They cannot be separated from each other. They always come with the pair. Shorts, slippers, sandals, stocking, trousers, spectacles. Now look at this one. You can make this plural noun in singular by using a pair of. I told you a pair. A pair of binoculars. You can make it singular by calling it a pair. But they will be two. But if we say a pair of binoculars, then it will be considered one pair. One pair, a singular pair hai. A pair of spectacles, a pair of goggles, a pair of pliers, a pair of shorts, a pair of jeans. We can only make a pair singular, but we cannot say jeanses or binoculars or spectacles. Like we cannot add any ES or VES here. They are just come together in a pair, but we can say a pair of binoculars to make it singular. This is your exercise. Choose the correct option for the each sentence here. You have given four options for each sentence. You have to choose the right singular or plural form. The plural nouns of kangaroo is what will be the? Yes, it is ending with the O sound here. So what we will do? Yes, kangaroos is the right answer here with double O and S at the end. Look at the second one. The plural noun of shelf here. Yes, we have discussed this. It is ending with the F here. So what we will do? Yes, we will add VES here. Shelves. I hope you can do these three by yourself. Look at the B section here. Underline the noun is the given sentence in identify the noun as singular or plural. You have to identify whether the noun in this sentence is are singular or plural here. You have to identify the noun. Noun is the name of person, place or thing here. In this first sentence, plates are the noun. So, we have S here, so it is a plural form here. Grandmother is also a singular, so that's why it's singular here. You have to identify these two. This is your homework from summer pack. This is also your homework from summer pack, page number 17. And this is also activity here and the other questions too. I hope you can do it very easily because we have learned the concept of and different way of changing from plural to singular. This is your home task from textbook page number 20. You have to identify different types of singular and plural form in this paragraph here. Give it a read and underline the plural and singular nouns here. I hope you have enjoyed my lesson. Thank you.